أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم مدد يا سيدي يا سلطان الأولياء يا شيخ شعب الله الفاضل الدارستاني مدد مدد يا سيدي يا سلطان الأولياء يا سيدي الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقان They are asking their madad in order that we reach Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And to reach Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not that easy, although many people they claim that they have reached Prophet and they get inspirations, and this inspiration word is so easy on the tongue today that everyone say, oh, I have an inspiration, or I have an inspiration, oh, I have inspiration. Hey, but are you thinking that this inspiration that you have, is it an imaginary inspiration, or false inspiration, or a true inspiration? How you can recognize that this is a real inspiration? It is not easy for anyone to say, unless if he is being granted that. Like awliya Allah, they are granted that, and they say that it is an inspiration. And that's why Allah said in Holy Quran, فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Allah inspired the self, what is good, what is bad. So you cannot say, I have an inspiration, if really you don't have an inspiration. Don't lie. And that's why awliyaullah, they know how much it is not easy to say, I got an inspiration. And I ask you, because you are always a grandson of Maulana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah give him long life. I'm not asking you to answer it, but I'm asking, and because you are here, because I saw that might be double of your age with Maulana Sheikh. And it is mentioned in many places in Holy Quran that Allah sent dreams, like He sent a dream to Sayyidina Ibrahim, go and slaughter your son, sacrifice your son for me. He didn't say inspiration. Inspiration is a direct message, comes from Allah directly to that person, and comes through the Prophet, from Prophet to that person. I ask you now, how many times Maulana Sheikh said, I went to rest, sleep, and inspiration came? Is what he says or not? Yes. Usually, yes. Most of the time. Yes, yes or not?
Yes. Huh? Yes.
Direct on him. He never say, it's coming to me now, inspiration like that. He never, the awliya are humble. Although it is every moment, they are in inspirations with Prophet ﷺ. But adaban, out of respect, they don't claim it. They don't claim except until they show their highest level of ajal, helplessness in front of Prophet. That they are saying, we need to lay down, get from you, and then we say it. Adab, this discipline. الطريقه كلها اداب. طريقه, all of it is adab. Every move we move is adab. I give you an example now. Someone might get upset, but since I saw it, I can give an example for this example. But that person must not get upset. For example, I am looking at, what's your name?
Abu Karim.
And in his hand beads. He is moving his beads. When the sheikh gives, not me, me has with you 100 beads even also, no problem. But when Maulana is speaking, complete adab. No, continue. It's okay. I told you, I'm giving an example. Prophet prohibited to use the beads or touch anything when the imam is on the member. مَنْ مَسَّ الْحَجَرْ فَقَدْ لَغَى. Prophet said, because at that time they didn't have beads, they used these stones. Anyone touch a stone when the imam is on the member, means he is making law, means he is making innovation in religion, he is making something mistake in religion. So many people I see when the imam is on the member, they are keeping using their beads, or if the telephone ring, they put their in their pockets and close it, even when they are praying. So close it before. If you didn't close it, let it ring. Don't move. Any movement, three movements in the prayer is gone. So what Prophet ﷺ said? أنصر أخاك ظالما أو مظلوما. Support your brother, oppressor or oppressed. Okay, we understand, we support our brother when he is oppressed. It's not. Sahaba asked, Ya Rasulullah, what about oppressors? How we can support our brother who is an oppressor? Is not? Is it? How? Oppressed? Every one of us is oppressed in such a way. So we have to support each other. That's why people come to the Sheikh, because the Sheikh supports everyone. Because people are oppressed. In many ways in their lives, there is a problem. You might be oppressed from your wife. You might be oppressed from your father. You might be oppressed from your mother. You might be oppressed from your brother, from your sister, from your son, from your daughter. Isn't that possible? So the Sheikh will try to makes you feel good. But what about the oppressor? Why we have to support the oppressor? Prophet said, "Unsur akhaka zaliman aw mazluma." Support your brother oppressor or oppressed. The Sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulallah, we understood oppressed. We understand it. What does that mean? Okay. But oppressor? And Prophet said to support him by telling him his mistakes. By telling him what you are saying is incorrect because they have already whispered in your ear by phone before the lecture or by phone after the lecture to deliver a message through you. They use you like a horse instead of saying something else. They use you. So you made a mistake, so next time don't make it. Try to avoid your brother not to fall into mistake. That's how you are supporting him, as Prophet said. Unsur akhaka zaliman aw mazluman, zaliman oppressor. Means when you see your brother is going to fall in a situation, going to be an oppressor, tell him, my brother, be careful, this is not true what is being said, because they are using you for fitna or ghiba or namima, which Prophet ﷺ prohibited them. Prophet asked, who is the poor? Who is the bankrupted? They said, the one that has no money, Sahaba, no wealth. He said, no. No wealth, still Allah sends him food and eats and shelter. Even homeless. One time I was passing in San Francisco, you know, all these bridges. The biggest city that has bridges in America.
San Francisco.
Many bridges downtown over each other. I was passing through the city and there were like three or four bridges over each other. And I saw a lot of homeless, askees from San Francisco. How many homeless there under bridges? They line up. But one of them has built a palace. Compared to the others, under these four or three bridges, they are crossing over each other. So, from three apartments, and he had a like a stair, wooden stair between them. And he go from one apartment to another apartment under the bridges, and they are naked from cartons, corrugated
boards.
He's happy. And we are not happy. Allah gave us everything, still we are backbiting each other. I will take your picture, I will bring my camera. The other one will say, oh, you are coming, I don't bring my camera. The other one will say, you bring your camera, I'm not bringing my camera. Huh? As if the camera is going to make you a person. Camera is an instrument to propagate Maulana's name. So if we have here 100 cameras, it's better than to have 10 cameras. Because every one camera has its own direction or final goal. Not to make it to look enemy. They are making it to look that like they are enemies here in Maulana's house. We are coming here to be happy, to be together. Not this one has permission to go up, that one has no permission to go up. That one can see the shape, that one cannot see the shape. That one, this, that one. No! It's not that. It's enough from the moment you move from your house saying, I'm going for Hajj, Hajj is written for you. You reach or not? If you reach or you don't reach, it will be written for you. If you say, I'm going for ziyarah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you step one step out of the house, it's written for you. Because you did your papers, you did your passport, you did your application, you finished everything. I'm moving, and an accident happened on the road. It will be written or not? It will be written. Anyone who stepped one step toward the masjid, and had a problem not to reach the measure. Is it certain for him or not?
Yes.
Anyone who comes to visit, not a masjid, a grave of a wali, it is written for him or not?
Their word. This, what you think if you are coming to visit a living sheikh?
You'll be rewarded as soon as you step out of your house with the first feet. It is written as if you have come, visited him, and going back home. Allah will reward you.
Now, what do you think about visiting Sultan al-Awliya, Mawlana Sayyidi Shaykh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqani? Is there any enmity anymore?
It's an ocean! We are diving! And when you dive in, you look at the ocean from outside, what you see? Shaykh Ahmed, what you see?
Water.
What color of water?
Blue.
Do you see anything else? Normally, do you see? Put the camera on him. Do you see anything more?
Waves.
Waves. No, you don't see. You need to dive. Dive a little bit. Is the whole scenery changed or not? Completely changes into a colorful sceneries, a nature that you never saw on earth. It is the nature of the ocean that has what Allah has created, that is miraculous. Fishes, different colors. Trees, different colors, birds, different colors, and as you dive down and down more, as you see more and more, what you think if you go to a masjid, Allah will not give you more than oceans? Not only seeing the minbar and seeing the cabinets here, and seeing each other, no. Allah will dive you, make you to dive in the ocean of that sultan that you visited. You are diving in his heart, taking you within his heart, where his heart is, he's taking you in. Awliya Allah, they have no limits. Allah gave them. So don't underestimate the greatness that Allah gave His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sahaba, A'imma, Awliyaullah. Don't underestimate what they have. But we are blind. When you go dive, can you go with your eyes like that? What you need to put? What you call it?
Goggles.
You have to put them in order to dive. And that is not enough. What you need to put also?
Oxygen.
Oxygen is the gas of life. Is the gas of life. Everything is gas in this universe. Coming from energy, when Allah said, Kun, everything gas came and took its shape. Oxygen makes you to live, hydrogen makes you to live. Both elements come together for motors. So you need the oxygen.
Wait, what is the oxygen?
The oxygen is the knowledge, the sophisticated rocket that awliya Allah they put on your shoulder through the awrat and through their love to you and you to him, that is the oxygen. That's why people, they say to each other, you are my oxygen. Not? You didn't hear that?
No.
You heard that?
Yes.
You are my oxygen. Means, without you I cannot live. Awliya Allah are the oxygen of this life. Without them, there is darkness. وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَعْمَى وَأَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا. Who is blind in this life is blind in Akhirah also. That's why Awliya Allah, they don't want you to be blind. They give you the awrad, they say these are the goggles. And then they give you the oxygen, they give you, this is life. Use them, I can show you what you cannot see with your eyes. That's why مَا زَالَ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ مِنْ نَوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ. My servant approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I will love him. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتَ, if I love him, if, there is if. So means you have to keep running, asking until Allah loves you. He said, if I love him. And when Allah say, if he approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I love him, means Allah loves you. Because this is a voluntary worshipness. Now here, sitting, while we are sitting here, coming to our Shaykh from long distances and sitting here, for what? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He loved us, he brought us together. Those who are here are lucky. Those who are not here also are lucky because their spirit are here. Any follower of Mawlana Sheikh around the world is present. Cannot be. We cannot say he is not here. Then we are diminishing the power of the Sheikh. The Sheikh can reach anyone. You don't need, he doesn't need you to reach him, he reach you. He said, if I love him, I will be his ears that he can hear with. Means you can hear what people cannot hear. Today what we are speaking just now, what we are speaking, there are instruments that can hear you. Your phone can hear you. There are chips in the phone. I was reading an article. Not only the phone, in everything. There are chips that release your voice, what is happening. Even it's closed, they can hear you. That's why you have to be a loyal servant to your country. Loyal person to your country. Don't say this east, this west. You live in the country you are living in, you abide with its law. أَطِيعُ اللَّهُ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولُ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. But Grand Sheikh many times, every lecture, the head of a lecture, every lecture he used to say, obey Allah, obey Prophet, obey the authority. I remember something that no one knows it, might be Sheikh Adnan only knows it. That Grand Sheikh used to say, I always pray for Hafiz al-Assad. Why? Because you have to obey the law. Allah put him on us, we have to obey.
Yes.
If I am living in the West, I have to obey the West. I have to love the West. If I live in Europe, I have to love Europe. If I live in the East, I have to love the East. I have to. Because it is حُبُّ الْأَوْطَانِ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The love of countries that you are born in or you live in is from faith. So don't come against your people, your president, your government. You lose. Surrender. We are normal, peaceful students of Mawlana Sheikh Nazim that never allowed out. I remember in the Lebanese war, he said, you don't carry any weapon. And at that time, everyone had a weapon. That weapon that you see today, a Kalashnikov. No, people, they have tanks on the streets. Rockets, RPG. He said, no. He said, even a knife, it is sunnah. I don't want you to carry a knife. Because he doesn't want our name to be written in the Lawh al-Mahfuz that we carried weapon. To obey. Because Islam is obedience. Ati'u Allah. Obey Allah. Ati'u Rasul. Obey the Prophet. Wa ulil amri minkum. And those authority on you. So Allah will give you ears that you can hear things that no one can hear. Eyes that can see things that no one can see. Tongue that can say things that no one can see, can say. Hand, you can move things with your hand that people cannot, you can move mountains. Let me go a little bit further in time, it's okay? If you have 1 ton of iron, iron matter, 1 ton, and someone tells you, carry it from here to there. Yeah. Can you carry?
Yes, sir.
No, you cannot. You cannot carry. So what you need? A machine, a crane. You bring a crane, but you don't put it, plug it in electricity, or you don't put gasoline in it. What the crane makes?
Nothing.
Cannot carry. You put electricity, what happened? Or gasoline, what happened? The crane lift the 1 ton of iron, or 2 ton, or 10 ton, or 20 ton, is not? What is this gasoline or electricity? It's energy.
Yeah.
It's energy. Grand Sheikh said, Allah gave energy to Awliyaullah, if they say to that mountain, move, it will move. Because they use the energy that Allah gave to them, which is better, energy of people, or energy of Allah that gives to people. Everything in this universe is energy. There is nothing except energy. If you go back to the atom and periodic table in chemistry, every atom is a consisting of mass and energy, electron and proton and neutron, and the mass. We are consisting of two, energy and body. I will not go deep into this discussion now, but if you release your energy that it is within you, then you can reach what people cannot reach. That's why Sayyidina Umar reach Saria in Damascus and Sayyidina Umar in Medina and say, Ya Saria, I was speaking to him from Medina to Sham, 3,000 kilometers, saying to him, Ya Saria, Jabal, run after the mountain, they are coming, the enemy from there. He was seeing them, he was hearing them. Umar was seeing and hearing, Saria was only hearing. The level is different. He heard the voice of Sayyidina Umar. Sayyidina Umar was able to see why. He's not a prophet. If they say prophet, but Sayyidina Umar is not prophet. So when Allah wants to give, Allah will give. Allah gave Awliyaullah. Gave Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. May Allah give him love. And what they say on their mouths, we have to follow. And let us see this, what hear what Shaykh al-Islam wa Mufti al-Shafi'iyya, the Shaykh of Islam and the Grand Mufti of Mecca, of Shafi'i school of thought, long time ago. He said in his book Taqrib al-Usul, and we discussed before that we have to accept what Awliya says because they cannot lie on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they see something from Prophet, see Prophet in the dream, tell them do this or do that, it's finished. He said, قال رأيت الله قال رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I saw Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He didn't say here in a dream or in vision. Means can be both. Because in other places, he says, رأيت النبي في الرؤيا. Here he said, رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقلت. I saw Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, I asked him, يا رسول الله, صلاة الله عشرا على من صلى عليك مرة. You said, we know that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, من صلى علي مرة صلى الله بها علي عشر. Whoever make one salawat on me, Allah will make 10 salawat on him. You know that. Everyone knows that. That is an authentic hadith. So what he said? He said, Ya Rasulullah, he turned it. The same meaning, but he began from the end. He said, Ya Rasulullah, Salatullah, Allah's prayer, Salatullah, Allah's prayer, 10 times on the one who say make prayer on you 1 time. Is correct? هل ذلك إن كان حاضر القلب? Is that required? Presence of the heart means you are doing meditation. Too many people today, they say, oh, what is this, what is this, what is this? I don't know what is this. And meditation, and what? Meditation in every book. Allah said it in the Holy Quran. Allah didn't say in the Holy Quran, الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ. What يَتَفَكَّرُونَ? Who knows Arabic? What يَتَفَكَّرُونَ? They contemplate. Those who make zikrullah, الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ, those who make zikr, standing, sitting and laying down, وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ, and they contemplate, في خلق السماوات والأرض, in the creation of heavens and earth. رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. Oh Allah, you did not create this wrong, باطل. It's haq. فَكِنَا عَذَبَ النَّارِ. Save us from hellfire. Allah said it in Holy Quran, contemplate. Allah said it, meditate, contemplate, tafakkar. Not only that, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, tafakkur sa'atin khayrun min ibadati, two narrations here. One it says khayrun min ibadati sana, it will be rewarded more than worshipness of 1 year. And it says also خَيْرٌ مِنْ عَوَذَةِ سَمْعِينَ سَنَى, or reward of more than 70 years of worshipness. He didn't say 100 years. I am correcting, someone said 100 years before in this masjid. It's 70 years. Either 1 year or 70 years. What he said? تَفَكُّرْ وَسَاعَةٍ, contemplation for 1 hour. It will reward you, O Muslim, O Mu'min, all of us. And if you sit on your knees or on your legs and you think for a moment about Allah's creation of heavens and earth, and about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about Prophet, about Awliya Allah,
about Holy Quran, about Holy Hadith, making zikr Allah, Allah, La ilaha illallah, salawat on Prophet, you'll be rewarded, reward of 70 years of worshipness. If you live 100 years, means two-thirds of your life with one contemplation, you already made two-thirds of your life of worshipness. I think something wrong? If I think something wrong, please correct me.
No.
I'm like you. I'm at this door. As you are at this door, all of us the same. One time I asked Maulana Sheikh, he said, this is my turban. I was on the plane with him going to Malaysia 20 years ago. He said, this is my turban. And you look on my turban, there is nothing but symbolic. All of it are different kinds of jewels. Diamonds, pearls, rubies, sapphire, everything. All my murids are on my turban with different color, they are different jewels. If one is out of place, my turban looks bad, my crown bad. Something wrong with my crown. So all of them the same. We are all the same. I cannot claim I am higher. I cannot claim that I am doing lecture, oh, you are some... No! If Maulana wants to pull this, he pull it in 1 second. If Maulana wants to pull it, he pull it in 1 second. How many awliya pulled from their murids to teach them? Adab, discipline, and then give it back. Don't claim anything to you. And don't say it's inspiration. I didn't explain this. This is very important. You have a TV? You have a TV? Okay. You open your TV, pictures coming fuzzy. Very fuzzy. You know fuzzy? Not clear. What you can say? Can you see anything? You see only a...
No.
Not noise, you see some traces of a something, you don't know what is that. If your connection is good, you see what?
Clear picture.
So don't say, and I'm not the one that you can cheat me in that. It is inspiration. Yeah, but it is fuzzy. Your inspiration is fuzzy. You tried, but it's fuzzy. When it is fuzzy, don't say it. Might be wrong. Imam Shafi'i, I come to you, Grand Sheikh's example. What he said. Because everything you have to take back to a source. He said, how I describe the four mazahib, the four school of thought. It's good? So, how you can describe them? Give you a little bit history about the four school of thought. But don't be upset. The Imam Abu Hanifa first came. Then Imam Malik. Then Imam al-Shafi'i, and between them there is 200 years. Imam Shafi'i came in 3 century Hijri. And Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, in the time of Imam Shafi'i. Their followers used to kill each other. Not in the meaning of killing, but needs to fight with each other. Because everyone wants to go and support his school of thought. So Grand Sheikh said one time, he said, if they ask me, what is, because these four imams explained the Sharia completely. I will say, yes, they explained the Sharia in detail. But according to Imam Shafi'i, and I will quote Maulana Sheikh, Grand Sheikh, when he was in Baghdad, he put his madhab in a book called Kitab al-Umm, the mothers of books. It's many volumes, like 30 volumes. Everything. When he was living in Baghdad. When he left to Egypt at the end of his life and saw the situation in Egypt, he modified his school of thought. He changed his school of thought under Kitab al-Umm, but it's different from the one that was in Baghdad, because he saw more corruption in Egypt. So what this gives you and I is something that there are things, fuzzy picture, not fuzzy picture. When he was in Baghdad, he has a good picture. He saw everything as normal, good, because it was good. When he went to Egypt, it was bad. It was more corruption. So he became more strict in his madhab. That's why if you go to Abu Hanifa, from Abu Hanifa to Imam Malik to Imam Shafi'i, ending with Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, you will see the strictest was who? Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, because his time was more corruption. And what do you think about this time? How many years ago? 1,200 years ago, Hijri. And still we say inspiration? What is inspiration? If the Sheikh say inspiration, okay. If the Sheikh say do meditation, yeah, we do. It works, it doesn't work. We are under the order. But we have to believe. If someone say it's coming to my heart inspiration, I say, Alhamdulillah, we accept, we believe, we don't have an argument. But don't say an inspiration for something that you know is wrong. Cannot. You cannot. And in an inspiration that might jeopardize the system, the tariqah. You cannot. Yeah, I can say Memo, mashallah, as Maulana, I heard it from Maulana many times, he's very, very sincere, very pious, very good person, good imam, very strong supporter, very tariqat person. I heard it. But that doesn't mean that, sorry, Sheikh, that if he tells me I have an inspiration, I say, okay. But if he say I have an inspiration that this book is wrong, no, then I cannot accept that. Yeah, it's, we are weak people. We are helpless. So he said, Grand Sheikh, and I will then come to the hadith and we finish. He said, Grand Sheikh, that if they ask me to describe the four school of thought, how I describe them? There is a mountain. Here, you see from the window, there is a mountain. I'll show the mountain. Show the mountain, Sheikh.
He's showing the mountain.
There is the mountain. No, you have to move the camera. You have to see the mountain. Lift it up. Yeah. So this is the mountain, no? There is a mountain. Because Maulana, from his place, you can see a mountain in Jabal Qasur, in Damascus. He mentioned on Jabal Qasur in Damascus, he said that is a mountain. Okay. We saw the mountain. That is a mountain or not?
So can you say it's a fuzzy picture? No, it's a mountain. Everyone say a mountain. But on that, on the top of that mountain, there is an animal standing on an animal. Can see. Because I can see the trees, between the trees might be an animal. And Granshia said, look at Qasyun, Jabal Qasyun, the mountain. From his house, you can see the old style house, but not the one that renovated. It's a mountain, it's a mountain. There is an animal. And they are asking me, what is that animal? I say, this is an animal. But is it a goat? Is it a sheep? Is it a cow? Is it an ox? But animal. So we believe this is a book. This is a book. Book. But what the book is about? How I can see the book? I have to go through the pages. See. He said, I have to go, he is telling them, to a scholar. They have every Monday, every first Monday of the month, used to have all scholars of Damascus coming to him, and then go Sayyidina Khalid al-Baghdadi on top of the mountain to make ziyarah for Grand Sheikh Sayyidina Khalid al-Baghdadi at that time. I have to go up to the mountain, not from bottom or far away. I have to hold his legs, the animal legs, the animal hands, and I say is an animal on two legs and two hands, because I saw them and I touched them, not only by seeing, by touching. Then I look into the eyes, in the ears, in the mouth, and say, is it a goat? Is it a sheep? Is it a cow? Is it a ox? Or deformed cow? Deformed sheep? Or deformed goat? What kind of color of eyes? What kind of color of nose? What kind of color of skin? I have to describe it very well in order to say what I am seeing is correct. Who is doing this today? This is Tariqa. Tariqa is, he said, is to go and make sure what you are seeing, you checked it, and you are seeing it one by one. Not to hear something and believe it without following the ayah of the Holy Quran. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا أن تصيبوا قوما بجهالة فتصبحوا على ما فعلتم نادمين. O believers, he didn't say over human being. O believers, he's pointing to the believers. He's pointing to go to check what kind of goat or sheep or what a kind of animal is that. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu in ja'akum, if a person corrupted came to you with a news, don't believe it. Fatabayyin, check it. Did you check it? Normally people don't check. They hear, this is backbiting, this is namima, ghiba, and namima. They don't check. And to see you come and be jahala, because you might attack someone with ignorance, with ignorance of the situation, you might go and attack, and then you are going to regret it. If you are not regretting, means you are not going to be perfect. And especially if you are a alim, you have to check. If you are a sheikh, you have to check. If you have you are a politician, you have to check. All politicians, most of them, they lie. They don't want to check. Newspapers, they lie. It's not. But in Islam, you cannot lie. In any religion, you cannot lie. In tariqah, you cannot lie. So what Imam Shafi'i said, the head of the scholars of Shafi'i at that time, he said, Ya Rasulullah, you said that Allah will make 10 salawat on the one who make 1 salawat on you. Is that need to for the heart to be present? And now you have beads. Yeah. Like Abdul Karim was doing. He was sitting, listening to me, and at the same time, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. I am listening, or sitting by video, TV, and watching TV, and making salawat. It's okay. Is the heart present? It's not. فَقَالَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا. No, it is not. It's not necessary. Yeah, look, Allah. Rahmatullah.
Allah.
Look, Allah's mercy. Look, Prophet's mercy, as Shaykh. Look how much you must love Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That Mashaykh, our Shaykh, gave his life for the love of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to walk from one village to another village in northern Syria. 5 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, walking until reach the second village to give da'wah. You know that? This is in the Naqshbandi book, go read it. He said, بَلْ لِكُلِّ مُصَلِّ عَلَيَّ وَلَوْ كَانَ غَافِلَ الْقَلْبِ. It is for anyone who makes salawat on me, even his heart is not connected, he is ghafil, heedless. Even if he's heedless, they will say, now some people, I'm inspiration. They say, oh, from where he's bringing this? This is it.
Zoom.
No? تلخيص المعارف في ترغيب محمد عارف. This فضائل الأعمال. They asked many scholars. They say, "Oh, this hadith is ضعيف. This hadith is ضعيف. This hadith." But they agreed, scholars of Islam, that even the hadith is ضعيف, and you do that, it's good because they call it فضائل الأعمال. You can use it for you to uplift or to bring higher your level of worship. No problem. He said, no, even you can make salawat on me and your heart is with something else. Your tongue is moving. وَيُعْطِيهُمْ is not only that, but Allah will give him أَمْثَالَ الْجِبَالِ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ تَدْعُو لَهُ وَتَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُ. Allah will give him mountains of angels that will make forgiveness on his behalf and they will pray for him. This is one time. Let us say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammad wa sallim. Now we have all these angels. We are going to get it because we are going to say to Imam Ahmad Zain ibn Dahlan, Imam Shafi'iyya, you said it in your book. We want to take it from you. Ahmad Zain ibn Dahlan, be careful. He died 200 years ago. And then he asked, وَإِذَا كَانَ حَاضِرَ الْقَلْبِ. If he was present, his heart was present, if he had his heart present, now for heedless, for someone who is not heedless, and he's making salawat on you, Ya Rasulullah, he said, فَلَا يَعْلَمُ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. No one will know, not angels, not me, what Allah will give that person. So what you need better than that? See the greatness of Sayyidina Muhammad. See the salawat of Sayyidina Muhammad. And I have more. But it's 1 hour now. We'll stop here. We'll continue tomorrow, inshallah. By his permission. وَمِنْ اللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ بِحُرْمَةِ الْفَاتِحَةِ. Thank you.
Ya Allah, selamu aleykum. See you next time, inshallah. Never mind, it's okay. Make salah ala nabi, visiting. If you are not doing anything, make salah ala nabi, inshallah.